This episode of TechZilla is brought to you by Domain.com.
Devin writes in, I'm in the market for a new laptop that can take the stress of Adobe Master Suite CS6. After you guys talked about the Acer Aspire S7, I was leaning towards an Ultrabook, preferably a Core i7 with an SSD and enough resolution to watch movies in native 1080p. I'm looking at a $1,400 price cap. Love the show, and it couldn't be any better, Devin. Well, thank you, Devin. We should probably point out the first thing to think about when you're looking at an Ultrabook, and I'm just going to pull up the big old Wikipedia entry. For example, the Aspire S7. That is your daily carrying laptop. The Ultrabook is a thing that Intel put together to promote the sales of Intel parts, right? So, you know, it's high-end sub-notebooks which are designed to feature reduced bulk without compromising battery life, low-power Intel Core processors, solid-state drives, and unibody chassis to help meet these criteria. So, you know, it's really simple. They basically put together specs that define most of the interesting stuff on an Ultrabook, including minimum battery life, which is going to determine the size of the battery inside of there, transfer rates, and then frustrating things like wireless display, touchscreen that you may not want, but that you're going to get if it's an Ultrabook. So we should point out there are a lot of thin, light laptops that are awesome, but technically aren't Ultrabooks because maybe they don't meet all of the points on Intel's spec.
True.
So, we should also talk about, like, I would worry a lot more about memory than going with a Core i7 over a Core i5.
That's a really, really good point. I wouldn't go less than probably 8 gigs, and preferably I would go as high as 16 in a laptop, especially when it comes to video and photography editing.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at it, so Adobe has, like, the minimum specs for Adobe are kind of like the minimum specs for Windows. They're sort of a fantasy world where you have all the time in the world to wait 25 minutes for your laptop to boot up, right? So if you go to, and we'll have a link to this to show up, the system and hardware recommendations beyond the minimum. So good is a dual-core Intel processor, better is a dual quad-core Intel processor, and best is an 8-core Intel processor. And as you start scrolling down, like, I would look at better as the minimum if I were living in CS6.
Yes.
and kind of the big thing here, especially if you want to do, like, real-time editing of like Photoshop or just not spending your entire life waiting around for video editing, an NVIDIA GPU for acceleration of
different
features. Yeah, and it's kind of funny, like, when you start looking at that, like, ultrabookreview.com has a list of 13-inch Ultrabooks with dedicated graphics. So, you know, I'm sure, I'm convinced there must be more out there, but you're looking at, like, at this point, 3 or 4
Pretty
Ultrabooks.
Much, yeah.
Yeah, and that's part of the problem, right? A lot of people don't think about gaming and Ultrabooks, mm-hmm. You know, in the same sentence. So if we go up to, like, if you start looking at, oh, where did it go? So right here I have a list of all of Dell's laptops that are Core i5, Core i7, have at least 8 gigabytes of RAM, and have NVIDIA discrete graphics. Whoops, there it goes. So, okay.
Pretty.
Well, if I go to, like, so there's 89 different models that have everything on that list but discrete graphics. And when you get down to having NVIDIA discrete graphics, the list gets really short. You get down to, like, 30 entries. And they're starting at, like, an i7. They're bigger. These are like 17-inch laptops. They're desktop replacements. They're like $1,000 to $1,500. And I think you have our shop, our house.
Hold on. Let me get some working out done.
So,
boom.
This is the closest we can get to our desktop editing stations.
That thing is huge.
From, like, you know, so Revision 3, Discovery Digital Networks. Michael, the producer, is in my ear right now. How would you compare this on a scale of 1 to 10, where 10 is a brand new desktop editing system with a decent GPU versus this? Where is this scale on the 1 to 10 scale?
6 to 7.
So 6 to 7 for normal editing, lower for the video compression when you're exporting. I mean, but this is also a monster.
It's huge.
You know,
I would not want to tote that around with me.
Core i7, 770M, a giant pile of memory. And that's kind of the big thing, right, for a lot of people, if they're doing, you know, Adobe Creative Suite, Photoshop, video editing, whatever they're doing, is having the giant monitor.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Which also means having the giant, this thing won't even fit in my backpack. This thing won't even fit in most backpacks. And that's kind of the problem, right? Because there is no such thing as a 17-inch Ultrabook.
I can fit this in my purse. That won't fit in my purse. But if you are stuck on an Ultrabook, I did find a couple that are pretty similar to what you're looking for. But when you go for Ultrabooks,
right,
those are going to cost more, too, because you're paying for that name. You're paying for that brand name, that Ultrabook yeah. look. So I found one. It's the Asus ZenBook UX301LA. I've actually checked this out in person. It is beautiful, but it's also $1,800. You get a solid state. You get 8 gigs of RAM, so on the better side, 8 gigs of RAM. And you also get an i7, and it's only 3 pounds. It's very pretty. It stays cool, has really good battery life. It's a beautiful machine, and it has an awesome display, too, because it's 2560 by 1440.
Yeah.
So you want HD movies? That's got HD movies. And then I found the X1 Carbon. This one's really pretty, too. It's also $1,800 because it's an Ultrabook, and it's i7, 8 gigs of RAM, solid-state drive, less than 3 pounds for this one. It is customizable, so you can increase the gigs of RAM if you wanted to. You can increase or decrease the CPU if you want to, and it has a stunning display as well. This one, I believe, is, let's find it real quick, 2560 by 1440 as well. 8 hours of battery life, really, really nice keyboard as well if you're worried about that kind of thing. But if you want to branch away from Ultrabooks, because those do cost less a lot of times if you want to get the same interior yeah. specs as well, the Alienware 14, and
such
you've got
deal.
One too, right?
Well, yeah, I was pulling up here, like, I'm still a big fan of Dell notebooks,
yeah.
Dell laptops, and the Alienware 14 is fantastic because for $1,100, you can get 8 gigs of memory, a GT750M, a 14-inch screen, because it's kind of funny, right? Because if you eliminate 17-inch screens, I think you take out like 50 of the 80 offerings from Dell that have discrete graphics and a
yes.
Core i5 and a Core i7.
And XPS that one also 15, gives you the option to upgrade to 16 gigs of RAM,
which
and
is
it has
pretty
NVIDIA.
Awesome. Yeah.
Yay. Super,
yeah.
super pretty. Though this one is touted as a gaming laptop, I have seen a coworker try editing on it, and it was very smooth. It was really crisp.
Yeah.
It's also really freaky heavy at 6 pounds. So if you want to tote around, you can.
No, this is freakishly heavy. This is like 8.5 pounds.
That one is like like the 1990s just came back.
Yeah, but I think, like, you know, the MSI G60 was another one you found.
This one is really pretty, yeah. It's only about 1,200 starting off, and you can mm-hmm. customize it, too, up to i7. You can do 1920 by 1080 display, so a very nice display for your HD movies. Also has NVIDIA graphics and 8 gigs of RAM starting off. Optional upgrades include an mSATA SSD, and it defaults with a 7200 RPM hard disk drive. So you can upgrade it from that 1 terabyte hard disk drive up to like a 256 or a 512 SSD.
You also might want to think about, if you're going to own this for several years, you
yes.
know, make sure there's a discrete hard drive and that the hard drive isn't actually memory soldered on the motherboard. Make sure you could maybe you start out with a regular rotating drive and then you upgrade to an SSD.
Mm-hmm.
Right? 'Cause you can pick up a really good 512 gigabyte SSD right
oh,
now
absolutely.
For $250 off of Amazon. Not a sale price, a normal price, and the performance is going to be fantastic. So figure out what you can do if you need to keep down around that sub $1,400 price point. You know, look at some of the options we gave you and look about, you know, maybe in 2 years you upgrade, and also decide whether or not you want to get, you know, more performance for less money by going with a desktop, especially
yes.
where the monitor is concerned.
Ah, so much fun.
So much fun.
I love computers. I want to buy all of the computers everywhere, but I can't afford it. There's more from Techzilla coming right up, like Instagram fun. But before we do, let's thank one of our sponsors. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you get the power to influence and control what people find when they search for you online. No domain extensions tell you story with the trust of a .com or a .net domain name. .com and .net domain extensions inject credibility into your online presence, and who doesn't want to be credible? We like domain.com because they're affordable, they're reliable, and they're super, super easy to use. Plus, even before your Techzilla discount, a .com domain is only $9.99 a year, and a .net is only $8.99 a year. Also, check out domain.com and Twitter at domain.com. The guys at domain.com give Techzilla an awesome discount. Get 20% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code TechZilla at checkout. That's 20% off, aka big time savings. Don't forget to use the coupon code TechZilla. And when you think domain names, think domain.com.